Welcome back. I hope you're all well. So in today's video, I thought I would share some of my least used designer bags with you guys. So these are bags in my collection that I hardly ever reach for anymore. And of course, I'm gonna go over why. Now, I still love all of these bags. Let me just get that out of the way. I love every single one of them, but they're just the ones that I just haven't used in like a long time. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and jump right into it. Okay, let's start off with this guy right here. This is the Gucci Patlog bag. I remember when I bought this, like I was head over heels for it. I had to have it in my life. I had absolutely no patience. Like I was running around store to store trying to find one, finally found one, and then it was all scratched up and there was like this whole big deal with this bag. And now it just sits there, and it's not, again, because I don't like it or I don't think it looks good anymore. I think I just have other bags in my collection that I prefer. And also, I think it's really heavy. Like, now that I'm like holding it and the strap is on the inside, but like, it is really heavy, so maybe that's a reason. And then another thing is that like this lock is so annoying, and I don't know if I've ever mentioned that before, but it's really kind of hard to close. Obviously, you know, now I'm trying to demonstrate it and it closes easily, but yeah, it can be difficult sometimes to close if you're wearing it and you're trying to like push this closed. I mean, just a little tiny issue, but yeah, I don't know. I kind of feel bad, and I actually considered selling this. Like, let me know what you guys think. Should I sell it or should I keep her? Next up, very sad, this Chloe bag. So many of you loved her, and I got this for Christmas and I love it. I think it's a beautiful bag. It's like, ugh, breathtaking to me. So pretty, but I've not been wearing it. There when I first got it for a while, I wore it quite a lot, like almost every single day. But after about a month or so, I kind of haven't like reached for it, and now it's just been sitting in my little bag cabinet. But yeah, looking at her on camera, I'm like, oh, so beautiful, such a pretty like bag. But yeah, I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the color. Next up is the Neverfull. I've talked about this so many times. I think this is an amazing bag. I'm not telling anyone not to buy it. I think it's great, fantastic, basic or not. But I only use this when I travel, and obviously there hasn't been a lot of traveling going on, so therefore it's like not being used at all, like whatsoever. And again, I kind of feel bad for it. I mean, and you know what, like, this video like kind of makes me rethink everything, because I have all these bags, and then there are some that I favor that I like use all the time and that I pick over others like every single day. And it makes me think, like, do I really need all of these bags? Like, do I? No, I don't. So what is wrong with me? I'm putting myself on like a buying ban or something like that. But yeah, I love this. Great travel bag, but not been using it. Moving on to the Chloe Fay. Love her. Love the color. She's absolutely gorgeous. But I think my mistake was when I purchased a second Chloe Fay in a color that I gravitate towards more, which just kind of made this one like take the back burner. Is that what you say? Take the back burner? I don't know. I don't know the saying, but anyways, it's just sitting on the back burner. Like, it's not being used. And I think it's because it's a color that I don't reach for, even though I think it's beautiful. I am more someone that loves like blacks and browns and whites, and this is blue. Last but certainly not least, which is probably going to be a shocker to most of you, is the Pochette Matisse. No clue what it is, but when I was sitting down thinking about this video, and I like, this was one of the first bags that came to my mind. Again, this is a bag that I love. I think it's amazing. I recommend it all the time. Such a beautiful, classic, everyday, practical bag. But the reality is that I have other bags that I enjoy so much more and that I use so much more. So I cannot even tell you the last time I used this, even before all of this started. Like, I cannot tell you the last time I reached for this bag, you know, just because I wanted to wear it because I like it. You know, I might have pulled it out if I wanted to pair it with an outfit for pictures or something like that, but just for, you guys know, like, if you love bags, like, you have certain bags that you reach for because they're comfortable, because they're easy, and because, you know, they're just, the most useful to you, if that makes sense, and you just like wearing them. And this is just, for some reason, not one of them. I don't know what it is. I guess I just have bags that I feel like are more comfortable and easy to wear. And when I say easy to wear, like, these are handbags, like, they're all easy to wear, but I'm sure you guys get me. Like, some bags are just more practical than others. Rather, it is, you know, the way they open or how they lay on your body or comfort, you know, anything like that. So yeah, but I definitely do want to wear this more because I do think that she's absolutely beautiful and she is very, like, worth it. And yeah, I kind of feel bad for all of these bags right now. Let me know what some bags are in your collection that you're not reaching for at the moment. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.